Never had the best screens or the best designs. They've never had the biggest sensors or the most RAM. Pixel has never really been about that. So this metal build, losing those hardware bells and whistles from last year, I actually think made it better, to be honest. So no radar system up in the top and the huge bezel for some flashy gestures I'll never use and face unlock. Instead, just a selfie camera cutout. All screen up on the front of this phone, thin symmetrical bezels. Like I said, it's not a stretch to say this is the best looking front of a Pixel ever, just by keeping it simple. The back material, we kept getting told by Google that it's metal, right? And it is, but then that metal is underneath a coating of this kind of soft touch textured plastic. It seems like it's wearing well. It doesn't have any staining problems or anything like that. Except the power button is still glossy. That's a little different from the rest of the body. But yeah, the result is this pretty clean and well-built design, no seams. I've seen some headlines of people getting Pixels that weirdly have the back slightly detached, like separated from the front glass piece here. Super odd, but clearly mine doesn't have that issue at all. It's water resistant, which is awesome. There's a classic, fast, reliable fingerprint reader back here that can double as a notification shade pull down if you're into that. And then there's a cutout in the back for wireless charging, which is clever. But overall, pretty understated, I would say. The phone is small. It's a 6-inch edge-to-edge display, but it's small. It's smaller than the iPhone 12, smaller than a lot of other flagships, and I think a lot of people will appreciate that. And I don't know what it is about this green tech, all this green stuff coming out, but yeah, green's not really my color. I would probably do the other color, which is black, or big brain status. You can grab a case from channel sponsor Dbrand and pick any color you want, and they've actually been refining their materials on this grip case, which has this new texture along the sides with literally tens of thousands of these tiny little micro dots on the surface to give you more grip, so it kind of feels like a tame version of that old one. Display on the front is par for the course. It's a 6-inch diagonal, 1080p, 90Hz OLED, and with the pretty nice colors and a decent max brightness, it's not, you know, quite the eye-searingly bright for outdoor visibility that the flagships are, but it's good enough for everything else. And I'll go back to the overall aesthetic. These bezels are thin all the way around, even through the corners, and most people, including me, are just gonna really like this display. But this is my review, and you'd wanna know the things that I noticed, so this is something I'm noticing. And if you care about this type of stuff, you'd want to know that you can see the difference. So now you know. Phone very many Snapdragon 765G phones at 120Hz, so this setup really is more balanced between performance and efficiency. And this phone never really felt slow, which is good. It just never felt quite as fast as 120Hz flagship to my calibrated eye. And I think that's actually more because of the display than the chip. So a lot of people got mad because Pixel was going down to a Snapdragon 765G, which is technically a weaker performer on paper than the one in the phone that came before it. How could they do that? But I actually think this was a great idea for the efficiency gains, and this is actually a performance difference that I think no one, including myself, would actually notice. So when you combine this chip and 8 GB of RAM with Google's software wizardry, you get a phone that feels just fine in everyday use and performance, and even through gaming, and a battery life that's actually mind-blowing. Developer settings, like I mentioned earlier, didn't kill this phone much faster. Keeping the screen on as often as possible didn't kill this phone in a day. I'm telling you, through gaming and watching videos and navigation and multitasking, like, this has been the most pleasantly surprising battery experience in a phone in a while. It just sips power.